Hello, everyone. My name is Cyrus Akrami. I'm actually not the head of EMEA marketing for Facebook. That'd be fantastic. But I am the head of EMEA marketing for Workplace by Facebook. So let's, before we get started, actually, let's do a little quiz. Raise your hand if you've heard of Facebook. Okay, great. Raise your hand if you've heard of Workplace by Facebook. Oh, that's great. That means I'm doing my job. So for those of you who don't know what Workplace by Facebook is, it is the enterprise version of Facebook. It takes all of those features that you're used to, that you recognize immediately, and turns them into a platform that you can use within your companies to communicate, to drive culture, and to collaborate faster. And we'll talk a lot more about this over the course of the presentation, of course. But there's a lot of fantastic companies that are using Workplace already, names like Heineken, GSK, and I'd like to actually congratulate ABSL, who recently joined the Workplace family. Very, very, very excited to have you. So we're here to talk about be part of something. I love that phrase, be part of something. Take a second, what are you a part of? Think about all of the communities that you're a part of every day. When I think about it for myself, I'm a part of Facebook, I'm a part of Workplace, which is a division within Facebook. I'm part of the marketing team. I'm also part of the Game of Thrones fan club at work. There's a lot of communities that I'm a part of, and those communities are the reasons that I go to work every single day. That's the same thing that we need to bring to all of our companies, to be part of something, to feel connected to our communities. And so over the course of today, we'll talk about what that means and how companies are doing it, and some examples of the best ways to do it today. So when we talk about the future of work, it's not about 10 years from now. It's what we can do today and in the next 2 years to create connected communities. So let's start. Does anyone feel like this is what work is like today? This feeling that we're losing the race against machines? There's a McKinsey report that came out that 800 million jobs are going to be displaced by AI, robotics, ML over the next 5 years. I mean, that's a lot. That's like 20 Polands. That's a lot of jobs. And it makes a lot of sense, right? Indeed, AI is progressing, but look at the tools that we're giving our employees to fight against it, right? We're using tools from the 1970s to try to fight a battle in 2020. Something doesn't work. It doesn't make sense. And it makes sense that the people who are going to be hardest hit by this change are those frontline workers, the people in factories, the people in your retail stores. Those are the people we need to think about the most because they're the ones who are actually closest to our customers. And the best part about all of this and the reason why work isn't working is that companies already understand this, right? Raise your hand if your company has a Twitter account or a YouTube or a Facebook or any of the above or an Instagram or maybe a division of your company has an Instagram account, right? You know that traditional email marketing doesn't work for your external customers and then you turn around and when you have the biggest announcement of the year for your internal customers, you send them an email with a PDF attachment. Doesn't make a lot of sense, does it? And so that's why we need to change how we view our internal customers. Only 34% of employees say that they're engaged at work. 34%. That's nothing. You can get a lot more out of your employees, and now we're going to try to understand how to do it. I love this quote from Richard Branson. It's our employees that we need to be thinking about. And I know that a lot of us think about this every day in our board meetings, in our management meetings. We spend a lot of time thinking about this, but how do we actually implement it? What does it mean to make our employees feel like they're part of work? And that's where building connected communities matters, right? It's not about replacing your employees, it's about augmenting them. I love the example of the Apple Store. Right, that experience that you have when you go into an Apple store, you meet someone, they're augmented by machine learning, AI, something in their hand that makes your experience that much better. Right, that is the fun, exciting, great experience that we want to put into the hands of every single employee. And the stats, the best part is the stats show that connected companies are better performing companies. And what does it mean to be connected? Means to have that sense of belonging, that connection to the mission, the connection to my management team, all of the above. And you can define it how you want to define it. We'll talk about 12 attributes that are key to it, but I want you to start thinking, what does it mean for your company to become connected? Because the stats, they don't lie. The stats are actually really, really strong. This is a recent Gallup survey that actually showed that connected companies are more profitable, they're more productive. For me, I love the last one, there's less turnover. The hidden costs of hiring are crazy. So if we can reduce those costs in some way, that's a big win for our companies. Connected companies can do that. Because when I feel connected to my company, I don't wanna leave. Think back to the beginning. The reason I stay at Facebook, the reason I stay on the workplace team is because I really love my job, I love the mission, and I love the people I work with. So how do you become a connected company? How do we get these stats? Well, Gallup came up with about 12 key attributes. I'm gonna put 9 of them up here. And if you want, feel free to, I see some phones out, take a photo. But really, we don't need to go through them all, but you'll notice some patterns, right? Mission, do I feel like I can do my job? So tools, technology, people, do my colleagues care about me? Those are some of the key attributes that make a company feel connected. And I'm gonna bucket them into 3 buckets. We're gonna talk about these 3 today. Authentic leadership, redefining what we mean by the knowledge worker, and last but not least, how we can augment our business workflows. This is kind of the fun, sexy stuff that might come a few years down the line. We'll wrap it up with that. Sound good? Great, perfect. So let's start a quick story about why I felt from day one that I was connected to Facebook. So on the left-hand side here, Cheryl had her 10-year anniversary a couple months ago. And on her 10-year anniversary, she had a couple options. Option 1, send an email to all employees, about 40,000 people with her thoughts. Who's gonna read it? Probably a bunch of people are gonna delete it. So instead, she posted. And she posted her thoughts about the past 10 years, and you can see thousands of likes, hundreds of comments, people actually engaging in conversation with each other about the thoughts of Cheryl's past 10 years. And there were some really interesting conversations going on. Some very spicy, very serious. Some were just, Cheryl, thank you so much, you're a role model for me. But the entire company was able to have a conversation. Imagine 104 reply alls to a company-wide email. Your company would come to a complete stop. That conversation that you wish you could have had as a company wouldn't happen. On the other side, it's me, the day I joined. My boss posted welcoming me to the team. Now, I didn't get 5,000 likes, to be fair, but I got a couple. Like, how many did I get? I got 49 likes. That felt pretty good for me on day one. And then in the comments below, people were saying, welcome to the team, Cyrus. We're so excited to have you. If you need any help, please come find me. I'm here to help you. Just a little emoji here or there. From day one, from the first second, I felt like I was part of the team. I felt welcome. That's what connectedness is. So, let's go back. Lead with authenticity. Let's start there. Authentic leadership. Some couple great examples recently about the importance of leading with authenticity. The first one I'll start with is Starbucks. So, Starbucks about 18, 24 months ago, had their CEO changed. Went from Howard Schultz, who's the person who literally built Starbucks from a little coffee stand to the empire that it is today, switched over to Kevin Johnson. And this is a very scary time for employees. What's the new mission? Are things gonna change? Is my job safe? Is there gonna be a reorg? And so they needed to make a decision. How are they going to communicate with their entire company about what they need to do and what's gonna come up and happen? So they started going live. They started using live video, because they thought through their options. Option 1, should we send a bunch of emails to our company? Well, a big problem with that is that not everyone has an email address. So already you can't even hit most of your company. Option 2, should we do a live town hall? I mean, that helps for everyone who's sitting there at headquarters awake at that time and didn't happen to be sick that day. So there's not that many options, but the option they chose was the ability to go live to the entire company. So they set up a little phone, the two of them sat down, and they used Workplace's live video feature to have a conversation with the entire company. Everyone in the company could ask them questions. They were giving thumbs up, some people angry faces. They were having a dialogue with the entirety of their company live. And that allowed that CEO changeover, that CEO handover, to happen as smoothly as possible because they were able to answer the questions of the employees as they were coming up. And they're not the only company that does this. The Royal Bank of Scotland, a big bank in Scotland, of course, they do the same thing, where Ross, their CEO, actually goes once a quarter, will go live and have conversations with different people on his team, just his thoughts. He'll just pose his strategy. One thing that they recently started doing, because they found that around their financial results, all of their employees were finding it very difficult to hear the news about how the company was doing through the media rather than through their own leadership. Right? And obviously there's regulatory reasons that has to be the case. But what they do now is the second their financial results comes out, they also make sure to post the same message internally to all of their employees. So that way their employees feel like they're getting the news and the authentic transparency that they need from their leadership to feel connected to their company. Now they're also doing additional pieces of work around HR. They've actually created entire communities recently around mental health and mental health awareness, helping employees be able to share their stories around mental health. So it's not just financial results. I think the other piece around making sure your employees' well-being is catered for is also important. But that's not it. We see it all over the place. Virgin, Atlantic, this is their former CEO, Craig Krieger, who's just taking a photo of himself out with the flight crew. He recently stepped down. Their new CEO, Shay Weiss, recently created a group. They have a group just called Ask Craig or Ask Shay, where you can go in as an employee at any time and ask them a question, and they'll either answer it for you or find someone on their team to answer it for you right within a post. We see this as well at Elk Shop. Here they're doing a fun little carpool karaoke style interview with their senior leadership, really humanizing them. Because remember, for many of your employees, the people that work for you, they still think of senior leadership as the back of a financial report in a photo like this. And that's it, right? There's not much humanism in that, right? We want to feel connected to our leadership. And how can we feel connected to that? Things like this connect us to our employees. And Danone, same idea. Video, being able to connect with Emmanuel, great examples. And the stats, this is hot off the press, actually. Brunswick Group, which is a consulting agency that focuses on communications, this came out this week. Digitally connected CEOs and leaders perform better than their peers. They perform much, much better than their peers. Look at the first stat, I think, is the one that's most important. People want to work for digitally connected CEOs. That's on Facebook. That's on Instagram. That's on Twitter. That's on LinkedIn. All of those. So, second, redefining the knowledge worker. So the knowledge worker, the person who owns the knowledge within your company, might not be the person sitting behind a desk back at headquarters. The person who probably owns a lot of the knowledge with your customer is probably with your customer. Not probably, definitely with your customer. And for a lot of your companies out there, they may not be connected to you in any way. And that's not great for two reasons. One, the information going back up to that back up the chain gets diluted. It sounds better at every level, so that by the time it gets to you or the CEO, it's good news only. Not great for when you're trying to lead. But same the other way. When you have an important message to show how connected your company is, if your comms plan is to post a poster in the break room and hope that someone reads it, you need a new comms plan. And you'd be surprised. There's a lot of companies out there who that is still their comms plan, right? And some of these stats really blew me away. 14% of employees feel connected to their headquarters. That is really low. Less than half of them feel that headquarters even understands what they do for a living. Really disconnected workforces out there. The interesting point, if you look at the last one, that business leaders know that collaboration tools and communication tools can help with this. In companies where they've actually deployed communication and collaboration tools, those percentages, 14% increases to 25%, and 48 increases to 63. So you see a real impact when you start looking at technology to help fix this problem specifically. Let's talk about a couple examples. Clarins, which is a cosmetics brand. Clarins UK specifically, 90% of their workforce is either in a shop or basically in a mall at a stand working on cosmetics. That is a very disconnected workforce. It'd be very, very lonely to be a Clarins store worker because you're disconnected from the entire company, let alone having an email address. You're just kind of by yourself. But that doesn't mean that you don't run into the same problems, run into the same issues. Need someone sometimes to ask, hey, something's going wrong. Have you run into this problem before? Can you help me? So we started working with them to help create a community for their frontline workers, which they were able to do. They create a little group. Anyone in that group can post questions like you normally would in any Facebook group. And they've seen some real business results from it. 95% adoption from that workforce, mainly because it's mobile first. And creating mobile first platforms are extremely important because remember, they don't sit behind a desk. They clock in, clock out. They don't even have a desk to check emails on. High net promoter score, high mobile adoption, but most importantly, their employee retention has gone up by 6%. 6%, that is real savings for them because they don't have to go through these long, arduous hiring cycles. Another great example, Delta, which is the US's, I think, second or third largest airline. They have 70% of their workforce is frontline. If you think about pilots, ground crew, they have a large need for getting their information out in the same way. But it's very similar to Clarins. Why I chose Delta, because what I think is really interesting is they have a large operations in Florida. And for those of you, I'm sure, know, Florida gets hit by hurricanes all the time. And actually, what they ended up finding was that they needed to find a way to make sure that their employees were even safe. So what they've started using is Safety Check, which I'm sure all of you are familiar with on the consumer side of Facebook. But this is something they could deploy to their employees. And what they found during a hurricane, their CHRO was telling me the story. They found during a hurricane that one of their employees was trapped in their house and they couldn't get out. And through Safety Check, they were able to actually send help, cut down the trees that were trapping them in and get their employee out. So if you want to talk about making your employees feel cared about, feel connected to your company, that's how you make them feel connected. Last two examples on this, DFS, which is a furniture retailer, sending each other tips on just how to clean furniture. Estee Lauder, they're sending out their most recent marketing packs. There's a lot of different ways that you can work to help connect the people that weren't connected because they're the ones closest to your customer. They're the ones we should be really thinking about because just because they're not deskless doesn't mean that they're not voiceless. So last but not least, that's what you can do today. This is the exciting part, the part you're waiting for, the future of work. How do we change our business workflows with all the sexy stuff that you hear about, chatbots, all that? So a couple examples that recently, Danone, they operate in 120 countries globally. That's a lot of languages to have to operate in. And if you're a leader, and you're thinking about, can everyone in my company read my message that's unbelievably important? How are you going to translate it? Well, one nice part is that auto-translate. This is AI. This is machine learning, by the way. I know, it seems like machine learning can be crazy and different, but no, this is machine learning. Very basic stuff is my punchline. I would work on, if you're thinking about the business workflows that you should focus on for AI and machine learning, I always say focus on the not so sexy ones, the boring ones, the things you do every day, and win those. And then as the technology gets better, that's when we can start doing better and better things. Virgin, another airline, Virgin Atlantic, they found that their number one favorite HR benefit was that their employees got to fly on standby for free. That is the number one benefit. Oh, yeah, it sounds great to me, actually. They could fly on standby for free, but the problem was they had to log into four different systems to book a flight. So the employees they found it so hard to use their absolute number one favorite HR benefit. So what did Virgin do? They built this themselves, actually. They built a nice, interesting chatbot. Is it playing? I'll talk over it if it's not. There we go. They built a chatbot that allows you very basic decision-making calculus on how they're able to find the most recent flight, and they want to say they want to go to New York, if it's free, and book it straight out of chat. Right? This is deployed to all of their employees internally and is getting fantastic feedback. So these are the type of processes or chatbots that I would start thinking about for your companies. If you're in insurance, one really hot one that a lot of people talk about is connecting to your CRM. Your employees are out on the road. I wish I could just chat a bot and get that name and email address back into my CRM. That's all I care about, right? It's that basic. It's those tasks that just take up 1 minute of your day, 50 times a day, your whole day. So those are the ones that I would start thinking about. Now, my last example is one of my favorites is Walmart. So this actually kind of connects everything that we've been talking about today. Authentic leadership, Doug McMillon. Doug McMillon was actually the number one CEO on Brunswick's report, the most connected CEO. And look at this quote. I mean, it's unbelievable. Doug has changed the game for them. They feel connected to him. He is the spark that they needed. I love that quote. It really ties it all together. Walmart not only uses Workplace, actually, to connect all of their employees, which we really love, but they've started looking at, and I think this is really, really interesting where Doug is pushing the company, they've started looking at Oculus and what Oculus can start doing and how AR and VR can start impacting their business. So if you watch the video, what they're doing here is a kind of theory that we're calling immersion, not theory, but the attribute that they're calling immersion. So this idea that you can trick your senses into being in a real life situation. So the situation that they have to deal with, have you seen the videos of Black Friday in the US? This is the Friday after Thanksgiving when everyone runs into the store and is buying all the clothes at a big discount. Do you know what I'm talking about? Yeah? Really intense for a store worker. It could be really intense, right? You've seen those videos where people just get toppled over. So what they've decided to start doing is for training and L&D, rather than sending an email, rather than printing out a photo, rather than showing a video, they've actually built an experience which makes you feel like you're in the store during Black Friday. I think Walmart is really pushing the envelope on what it means to be a connected company. They have their connected CEO. They're connecting with their frontline workforce in a new way to get feedback in two-way directions. And finally, I think they're doing an amazing job looking at those little small processes that they need to change every day and looking at how technology can make it even better or even easier. So, in summary, that's what I would take away. Number one thing that I would take away, especially for the people in this room, how are you going to lead authentically? Number one, it's going to change how your employees connect with you. It's going to change how you connect with the company. It's going to change how people connect with the mission of what you're trying to do. From there, think about the knowledge worker. Who is your customer? Who is your internal customer? They're just as important as your external customer. And finally, over the next few years, let's work together. Let's find some really exciting ways to augment business workflows. Because at the end of the day, it's your job to turn your company into a connected community. Thank you so much. My name is Cyrus Akrami. I really appreciate it. I'll be around for another hour or so if you want to connect. Have a great day. Thank you.